Welcome back to another week of Our Kids Online. My name is Allie.
And I'm Katie. We are so excited you're hanging out with us today.
Yes, we are. So, we have another day packed full of fun things to do with you. And before we get to that, just a quick reminder, today is communion. Mm-hmm. What will they need for communion?
Well, you can grab any kind of juice or cracker. Mm-hmm. If you got a Sunday Funday bag, there was actually a little communion cup in your bag. So if you have that, or if you have that with you, have it ready.
Yeah. All right, guys. So we have been talking about, in our new series called Grow, we've been talking about the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And let's see, which ones have we learned so far? Do you guys remember? It's been love. Joy, mm-hmm. peace, and do you know what our next one is today that we're learning?
For today, it's patience, right?
Patience.
Yes.
How are you guys with patience? How are you with patience?
I think I'm okay at being patient.
You do pretty well. Yeah, I struggle a little bit sometimes. Okay. I'm like, I just wish these cookies would hurry up and finish baking.
That's true. Or it's like hard to wait for
lines. They're tough just to wait in, you know? It's hard to be patient sometimes. Mm-hmm. Are you guys good at patience or do you have a hard time? Let us know.
Yeah.
So today we're gonna do a challenge.
Yes.
We have a challenge for you.
I'm so excited.
Yes, and we're gonna use one of our items.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Which one are we using today, Addie?
I think today we are going to use our fruit by the foot.
Fruit by the foot.
Yes. Katie,
Are we doing the fruit by the foot challenge?
Oh, you know it. Yes.
Yay! Yes.
Today we are doing the fruit by the foot challenge. Okay. Have you guys ever done this? We haven't.
No, we haven't.
A little bit nervous, but I'm gonna call it today. I'm gonna call it the patience by the foot challenge.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. I like
because,
that.
Because you know we gotta learn how to have lots of patience. Mm-hmm. Patience by the foot is what I'm gonna say. So. Do you want to explain the challenge to everyone if they don't know what this is?
So what we're going to do is we're going to pick a fruit roll up, or fruit by the foot. We're each going to get one, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to unroll it all the way and put one end in our mouth.
Okay.
And then on the count of three, we're going to go and we're going to see who can get the whole thing into their mouth, right? Not eat it.
Oh, not eat it?
Maybe eat it. Is that what you do? I've never played. I'm making things up, friends. So you try to eat it.
Yeah,
as fast as you can. I know you have to get in your mouth as fast as you can. So we have to eat it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because, you know, you don't want to have to like
spit it out
later.
And then if you get it all in your mouth, it's going to be like so filled.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think
eat it as fast as you can.
Yes.
Okay. I knew you were just trying to bait the other person and try to be really fast. So, okay.
So this could potentially be a little gross, but.
Yeah.
We do it for you guys. All right, are you ready? Oh wait, we're gonna open them first.
Let's open
and
it.
And unroll them.
And then we're gonna
unroll them.
Do a countdown.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, okay, and these.
Oh wow,
so
smells so.
There are different flavors you can get in this box. There's cherry and orange or blue raspberry and grape.
Yes.
I think Allie and I both have the grape blue, and blue raspberry because that one just sounds like it's gonna taste better.
It does.
Oh my gosh.
So we should unroll it all the way.
Way longer than I thought it was gonna be. Is it actually a foot? No.
I think it's like 3 feet.
Foot?
I think it's like 3 feet, guys.
Oh no.
Oh, there's two pieces here. Oh, these are interesting. That's okay.
You eat them together.
Yeah.
If you get this kind. If you get a kind with two.
Guys, I haven't had this since I was like in elementary school.
Oh no.
Wow, it's just gonna have to be stuck together like that at the end.
Yeah, mine is two. Okay, that's the end we put in our mouth. Yeah. We'll start there.
Wherever you want.
I'll start on this side.
Okay.
Okay, so we take the paper off.
I'm gonna kind of pull it off as I go.
Oh, that's smart. How so it doesn't get on because it's on the table. You don't wanna I just touched the whole thing. So. It's okay, it's my germs. Don't touch your friends or your siblings.
Yeah.
You're by the fight. Okay.
Okay. Are you ready? To do this?
All right, Zach is in. Yeah. Do a countdown. Oh
Zach,
no.
Can you count us down?
I'm so nervous. We have not tried this, friends, so we do not know how it's gonna go. All right, let's get in our mouth. Let's put it in your mouth and then.
Okay.
Then you count down, okay?
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go.
It's so much. Be careful with this at home.
Wow.
Don't choke on it.
Yeah, be careful. I think I won that one.
I really did. Oh my gosh, you already ate it all.
And I also think that my teeth and everything is purple and blue, right?
Oh.
So we've changed colors, but that's okay.
It was all in my teeth, so I'm not gonna smile. It just stuck. That was a lot. Oh man, I can't get it out of my teeth, friends. Have water next to you when you're drinking.
Yeah, have some water. Well, we're gonna go get cleaned up.
Yep.
And get it unstuck from our teeth. But before we let you go, we're gonna pray and then we will get into everything that we have for today. Are you ready?
Kyla's gonna pray.
I'm gonna pray.
Because I have everything stuck in my mouth.
Katie's still struggling. All right, let's pray, guys. God, we thank you so much for today. We are so excited that we get to learn about you and have fun doing it. We love you, God, and we pray for all these things in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Hey everyone, my name is Ms. Dale. Are you ready to say this series Bible verse? This month, our verse comes from the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 22. And it says, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things, there is no law." I love this verse because it helps me remember how God wants me to live my life. I'm going to say this verse again. This time I'll say it and you'll repeat after me. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things, there is no law. Galatians 5:22. All right, guys, let's say it together one more time. Ready? But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. Galatians 5:22. You guys did great. Keep practicing and you'll have it memorized in no time.
Slapstick Theater, Paul and Felix. This is Paul.
Oh, hey.
Who told people about Jesus in lots of different places. Many of the Jews did not like what Paul was doing. So they made a plot to kill him. Since Paul was a Roman citizen, he was taken in by the Romans.
Oh.
So they could find out what the Jews had against him. Paul was sent to Felix, the governor at Caesarea. The Jews brought their case before Felix. They said that Paul was a troublemaker and was stirring up riots among the Jews all over the world. Then Paul got his chance to speak. He said that he was not stirring up trouble at all, and that these men couldn't prove the things they said of him. Paul said that he believed everything in the Jewish law, for he was a Jew himself and a follower of Jesus. Then Felix concluded the council and pushed it off until someone else could decide the case. He ordered Paul to be put in prison, but his friends could still visit him and take care of him. A few days later, Felix and his wife, who was a Jew, sent for Paul. Paul told them all about his faith in Jesus and the truth of what Jesus said. Felix became afraid and sent Paul away.
Go away!
For the next 2 years, Felix would call Paul before him and talk with him often. Felix hoped that Paul would bribe him, but that did not happen. After 2 years of this, Felix was replaced by a new leader. Felix wanted to gain favor with the Jews, so he left Paul in prison. Paul would go on to have many more trials, but through it all, he continued to speak the truth of Jesus.
Love, joy, peace, patience. Today we're going to talk about patience. Here's a joke. You know why I'm not a doctor? Because I have no patience. Very funny, right? Well, how many of you have patience? How many of you love to wait for things? Some of you might answer, I don't mind waiting if I don't have to wait long. And some of you might say, I like to wait if I get to have something good while I'm waiting. But most of us would say, no, I don't like waiting at all. I wish I never had to wait for anything. Today's lesson talks about a time when the Apostle Paul had to wait. In Acts 24, we hear that a bunch of Jewish people were trying to get Paul in trouble with the Romans. They were hoping they could get him killed. That's pretty hateful. But as if that wasn't bad enough, after they lied on him and said he was stirring up fights and causing trouble, he got chained and thrown in jail by his own people. But Paul was a Jewish man. Why'd they do that? Paul finally got a chance to speak for himself, and he told Felix, the Roman governor of Judea, that he wasn't causing any trouble. Felix didn't even say whether he believed him or not. He just threw him back in jail. And then he kept showing up to visit with Paul. He did that for 2 years. He even tried to get Paul to give him money to release him. Governor Felix was full of all kinds of bad decisions and unfairness. Do you think you would be ready to do almost anything to get out of prison? I think I would. I bet it was pretty hard for Paul not to just pay a bunch of money and get out. But Paul did the right thing. He waited on the Lord and he did not pay a bribe, but neither did he back down. He hadn't done anything wrong, and he continued to let Felix know that whenever he would ask. Paul had a huge amount of patience to be able to continue waiting for the Lord to cause him to be released from prison. At the end of this story, Paul is still in prison, waiting and continuing to do the right thing. You know, not every story has a super happy ending. But that doesn't mean that God isn't pleased by it. By now, a lot of you already know that sometimes you do things that are right and nobody really seems to appreciate it. Has that ever happened to you? Well, when that happens in your life, I want you to know that God loves to see you wait patiently on Him. While you're waiting, it's a good idea to pray and ask God to help you to stay patient. And you can also ask God to bring whatever it is that you're waiting for. There are times when the Lord will allow you to wait for something because people around you need to learn from your good example. Like when you and your friend both want the same thing for Christmas. Your friend gets it and you don't. But you're still glad that your friend got what they wanted. That's not your favorite ending to the story though, is it? But God would be very happy with your attitude and your friend would be so glad that you didn't get mad at them or start feeling sorry for yourself. Another time God may allow you to wait for something is when He's teaching you to be more patient. He's growing you up spiritually. Patience is something that you have to grow in. And as you grow in patience, you are able to please God more and more. That's all part of what's called building character. Patience builds character. Character is doing what's right, even when there's no one around making you do it. So what have we learned? God let Paul wait, and he continued to wait on God, which pleased the Lord. That was an example for us. We will sometimes be allowed to wait for some things as well, to grow us spiritually and to build character in us. Waiting helps us to do both. And when waiting gets hard, we can pray to God and ask Him to help us to be patient. We can have patience and wait on the Lord. Patience can be a really hard fruit of the Spirit to grow. But you can do it with the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. There is only one way to receive that power, and that's by receiving Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. In Romans 10, verse 9, the Bible makes it clear and God made it easy. It says that if we confess with our mouths that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in our hearts that God raised Him from the dead, then we will be saved. If you believe that today and you're ready to confess with your mouth, I'm going to pray a prayer, and you can say it after me, but believe it with all your heart. Let's bow our heads. Say this after me. Dear Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I've done wrong things. I'm sorry for all of my sins. Please forgive me. Jesus, I believe in you. I believe that you died on the cross for me, and you took all of the punishment for my sins. I believe that you're alive today. Come into my life today be my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. So wonderful. Hey kids, if you just prayed that prayer with me, that's the best decision you will ever make. We're so proud of you and we're excited for you too. There are two things I want you to do right now. One, tell your parent or another trusted adult that you prayed to start a relationship with Jesus. Two, we want to celebrate with you and send you a little gift. So let us know you prayed by texting the word KID to 313131. That's K-I-D to 313131. And welcome to the family of God.
We're back, and Ms. Roxanne just taught us all about the fruit of the Spirit called patience. Mm-hmm. She said that when we have patience, it helps us build character. And what else does it do?
It grows us spiritually, too.
That's right.
So it's really important to develop that fruit of the Spirit called patience. I know that, you know, it's something that I'm going to work on, too.
Yeah, for
sure.
So
this week, have patience with your brother, with your sister. Have patience with your mom or dad. Mm-hmm. Practice having patience with your friends or with schoolwork or whatever it is. There's lots of opportunities that you can take to learn and grow in the fruit of the Spirit called patience.
That's right.
Yes.
All right, friends. Hopefully you have your communion elements.
Yes.
We're gonna do communion now. Don't worry if you don't have your little communion cup. You can go ahead and just grab any cracker, any juice that you have at home.
Yep. Pause the video and then come back.
Yes,
and
run. We'll count down, ready? 3, 2, 1,
go. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll take, if you have a cup, peel back that top layer and you can take your piece of bread. And, you know, the Bible says that the bread represents the body of Christ that was broken on the cross for us. And so we are gonna go ahead and pray over the bread and then we'll take it together, all right? Jesus, thank you so much for today. Thank you, God, just that you sent your son Jesus to die on the cross for us so that we could have a relationship with you. Thank you that he just allowed his body to be broken and that he took the punishment for us on himself. We love you, Jesus, and in your name I pray, amen. All right, guys, let's eat the bread together.
All right, so now we're gonna
take our
carefully. Juice. Yeah, don't get it on yourself.
Oh, or the couch.
All right, so the juice is a representation of Jesus' blood that was poured out on the cross for our sins. When he died on the cross, he took all of our sins, so now we can have a close relationship with God, which is so awesome. So that's why we do this, just to remember what he did for us and that now we're free from sin. So we're gonna go ahead and pray, but before I start praying, I'm gonna give you guys a few seconds to just close your eyes and talk to God and say the things that maybe you have done against him, like maybe some of the sins you did this week, just to kind of get your heart right with him, right? So go ahead and take those few seconds. And then I'll go ahead and pray over us, all right? So let's close our eyes and talk to God and get our hearts right with him, and then I'll pray, all right? Dear God, thank you so much for your son that you sent him to earth to die for our sins. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that was poured out as a covering of our sins, God, that we are forgiven of our sins and that now we can live in close relationship with you. God, so we're just so thankful. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, let's drink it together.
Great job, guys. We love doing that every month and just remembering and taking a moment to remember what Jesus did for us on the cross. That is the most important thing we could ever, ever know and experience is salvation through Jesus because of what he did for us on the cross and that he rose again. So
that's great.
That's why we love to do communion.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So what do we have here?
Yes.
What is this?
We have something very special coming up next weekend.
Ooh.
Can you, do you know what it is?
Is it your birthday party?
Is it
your birthday?
No. My birthday is coming up soon.
That's right. It is in this month.
Yeah. It's this month. It's in May.
But it's not next weekend.
Okay. Next weekend, we are celebrating our moms.
Yes. Or the mother figure in your life.
Yeah.
Maybe your aunt, your sister.
Cousin.
Yeah.
Or a teacher.
Ooh, yeah.
Whoever is that mother figure in your life, we want to celebrate them with you. So, in your Sunday Fun Day bags, you received this little booklet.
It says, like, Faith Starts at Home, Mother's Day Edition.
Mother's Day Edition.
Love
it. And you should have also gotten one of these spinners. It didn't come attached, so you'll have to attach it.
You just cut a little hole.
Yeah, we just cut a hole.
And put it in.
And this is for a little game, so we're gonna go ahead and play the game, and then we want you guys to do this with your moms at home, and you can use this the whole week leading up to Mother's Day.
That's right.
So, yeah, there's lots of fun things to do.
So we're gonna spin the little arrow guy and see what it lands on.
Okay, you go first.
Okay. Sing.
So now what do we do?
Okay, so on the back of the little pamphlet, it has little, so they're color coordinated. So sing is kind of like this gold color.
Oh.
So I'm gonna go back and go to sing. Oh, it says
scan me.
Scan me. So how you do that is you take your phone, you open your camera, right? And then you hover over the little QR code.
Yep.
And you click on it, and it takes you to, a YouTube video for the sing.
That's awesome.
And you get to sing with the song.
Yeah, you and your mom will sing
together.
That's
so cool.
That's really cool.
Okay, all right, Allie,
so I'll go, and we'll see what it lands on.
Okay.
Ooh, that was a good
one. That was a really good
play.
Spin. Ooh, what's that?
I love to play. Who doesn't love to play? play on a piece of paper, write a prayer. Fold it into an airplane.
What?
Paper airplanes. Take turns sending your prayers into a God box or hula hoop a few feet away. That's so cool.
Oh, that's really fun.
That's really fun.
Yeah.
So you can write down your prayers on a piece of paper, make it into an airplane, and send it off as if you're sending it off to Jesus.
That's really cool.
That is cool.
There are a bunch more different things you can play at home.
Yep.
So go ahead, make sure you get this.
Yes. It's in your Sunday Funny bag.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's other stuff on the inside, too, that you guys can do. So lots
there's
of activities. And y'all will have so much fun doing this together. Looks like there's a little puzzle and a couple other things. So have fun with your moms this week or the mother figures in your life. And, we'll see
and you guys. And on Mother's Day, for our Mother's Day video, we'll have even more to show you that you can do to show your mother or mother figure that you are thinking of them and that you want to celebrate them.
Yeah.
So be back here next week.
We'll have a fun craft. So come ready. All right, guys, we love you, and we've had so much fun with you today. We'll see you all next week for another week of Our Kids Online. Bye.
Bye.